Total adrenaline, where fun is made. Top tip, don't fall off the swings. Keep bouncing.
Come to Len's barbecue.
Is your mum and dad going down on the train?
Yeah.
They want to build some. Oh, they're starting it. They're signing tomorrow.
Simon. And you're so vain on BBC Radio Manchester. Thanks very much to Phil. And for the next couple of hours, you've got me, Jason Harding, playing you the songs that you've been emailing and writing into here. It's an all request, nothing but the 70s. Will your famous 70s song be played? Keep on listening to find out.
FM, online, digital radio, preview channel 719, and on your smartphone.
BBC Radio Manchester.
It's 12 o'clock midday. With the news, Richard Stets.
Two British men who are believed to have been members of the Islamic State gang known as the Beatles have complained that they can't get a fair trial because the UK government have stripped them of their citizenship. The pair were captured by Kurdish fighters in January. They're accused of being part of the gang which murdered more than 20 hostages, including the Salford aid worker Alan Henning.
Low fuel.
Major General Chip Chapman is the former head of counter-terrorism.
You're going to go to Shell, or do you think you'll be all right?
The complication is, at the moment, they're held by the SDF, that's the Syria Democratic Forces, who, of course, aren't a state themselves, who lack any official authority to negotiate with foreign governments. Trying these people, indeed, if they'd have been captured in Iraq, they could have been tried and had a determination in Iraq.
A fourth teenager's been charged after a man was attacked on a tram platform in Oldham earlier this month. The victim was taken to hospital with serious injuries and is now recovering from his ordeal. Rebecca Kelly reports.
A 49-year-old man was beaten and left unconscious at the Freehold Metrolink close to Oldham town centre earlier this month. The incident was captured on CCTV and there followed a police appeal to catch those responsible. Since then, two 15-year-olds have been charged with attempted murder and another 15-year-old's been charged with assault. Now a 16-year-old boy's also been charged with attempted murder.
A special school in Stockport is to appeal against a decision to reject their plans for a new building on their existing site in Cheadle-Hume. The Seashell Trust wants to build a new 45 million... At Old Trafford in the Premier League this afternoon, Ashley Young is a doubt with a knee problem, and midfielder Scott McTominay is set to be available despite suffering a calf injury on international duty. And New Mostyn's Anthony Crawler is preparing for his first fight since September. He'll take on the Mexican Edson Ramirez on the undercard of Anthony Joshua's world heavyweight title fight against Joseph Parker in Cardiff tonight. Greater Manchester's weather mainly cloudy this afternoon with further spells of rain and drizzle. Highs of 7 Celsius.
Radio Manchester, travel update.
Sunday afternoon, which means 2 hours of songs from the 1970s, chosen by you. Where will your song feature in the show today? We'll find out shortly right now, Samantha Dean.
Thanks, Jason. M66 northbound, the lane has now reopened at Junction 3 at Hollins. It was on the exit slip road, a lane closure because of a broken down vehicle. That's now being recovered. Hamforth and the bypass, queuing traffic there at the A555 Manchester Airport Link Road. We still have that closure in Staley Bridge of Clarence Street because of a building fire a couple of weeks ago that's deemed the building unsafe. So that closure in place between Park Road and Bailey Street, also affecting Thames Street from Clarence.